welcome to another motion graphics adventure that no one but you is watching. Consider it our secret one-on-one class. So today we are going to dive into motion tracking magic, attaching text to a spinning floor and adding smoky exhaust trails to moving motorcycles. Just you, me, and some good old After Effects fun. So this is our starting point. I've already placed this text on screen and we are going to use this free Adobe stock clip of those two motorcycles. The first task is to track the text and make it spin as well as scale up. And for that, I'm going to use Mocha AE. So I'll select this clip, go to the effect menu, and from the Boris FX Mocha menu, I'll launch Mocha AE and then click to actually start the application. Over here, I'll select the circle or the elliptical X spline layer and create a circle over here. And it's important to check, at least at the beginning of the shot, that the motorcycles are not going to overlap with the pixels within the tracking area. All right, I think it's good. I'm going to switch off skew. I only need rotate, scale, and transformation, and then I'll analyze forward. And as you can see, Mocha doesn't have any problem tracking the pixels inside the tracking region. Let's just wait for it to finish. And once it does, we can save our progress and exit out of Mocha. Now I'll go to the layer menu and create a new null object. I'll name this null MT for Mocha tracking. And because I plan to add a few null objects, I'm going to colorize this one, let's say blue, so it will be easier to recognize. Now I'll reselect the video with the Mocha effect, click on Create Track Data, and then for the export option, I'll change it to transform. And for the layer export to, I'll change it to the empty null object. And finally, I'll click apply export. Now, if we'll select the null object, we can see that it moves and scale with the shot. So all we need to do is select the text layer and then use the parent pick whip to point it to the null object at the beginning of this comp. And then if I'll preview it, you can see that it is tracking and scaling and rotating with the image. And I've set it so at the end, as you can see, it will face us straight and it will be easier to read. Seems like I have a sixth sense when it comes to this project. All right, now let's make it a little bit more in line with the texture that we're seeing here. And to do this, I'll add the roughen edges effect to the text layer, change the edge type to photocopy and reduce the border to 2. And I'm also going to change the blending mode of this layer to multiply. And if we're going to preview again, you see that it looks much nicer. Now I'm aware that we need to key out those motorcycles. I leave it to the end because now I want to show you how to track the bikers. Now this part is a bit tricky, so we'll need to manually fix it when needed. Let me show you what I mean. I'll select the video and then I'll right click and choose track and stabilize track motion. Now, if you're working with the newest versions, you may see this arrangement where the layer panel is just near the composition panel. And I just hate it because right now it doesn't make any sense because we are not doing anything specific in the layer panel. So we can't really see anything in the composition panel. This is the idea behind this new layout. We're just collecting data. So what I'll do is click on the word layer and I'm going to move it to be one of the tabs as it used to be before. All right, now I'm just going to press the period key. You can, by the way, also zoom in and out by using your scroll mouse. And this is so I can click when I'm seeing the double-headed arrow to select all the tracker elements. So this is the attach point. This is the area that we're going to track, and this is the search. I'm going to move it to some contrasty point, let's say somewhere over here, and then we can modify it. We can make it a little bit bigger in terms of the search area. And let's leave the tracking region as is by default. I'll zoom out so I can monitor the process and let's analyze forward and see what we are getting. So for the first part, it looks quite good. And then I think that I'm going to stop it. At some point, it will start to drift as you can see over here. And if this happens to you, what you can do is just move to the place when you think it was the last good point. So somewhere over here. Again, I'll zoom in so I can see what I'm doing. And then I'm just going to move this just a touch to redefine the After Effects confidence level. Because what's happening behind the scenes, if I'll open up the tracker options in the timeline and have a look over here, you can see that After Effects has this amount of confidence level. And if I'll click on the options, When it is under 80%, it starts to adapt the feature. So it starts to guess. Now, if you want to control it, you can actually tell it to stop tracking when the confidence, let's say, is below 85 or whatever you want to define it. And let's see how this works. I'll zoom out and I'll continue to track from this point. And we can see that, of course, when it loses this confidence, so confidence level is under 85%, it is basically stopping. Now, in this point, I think it is still working quite good. So I'm just going to try and click again on analyze to continue and track forward. Or I can just click outside and then reselect all the tracker points and move them again to redefine a new 100% level of confidence. And of course, I can also change the track area. Now, if I hold down Command, Control on Windows and grab one of the corners, I can change this box asymmetrically. So maybe something like this will work better. And again, let's try to analyze forward and again. And what I'm doing is just clicking on the analyze forward every time the tracker stops. And this is just going to allow us to get a more accurate track without After Effects trying to guess on its own where it needs to be. So it looks like a manual labor, but at the end, you'll get a much more accurate result by using this method. Now we need to do the same thing for the second backer. So let's go to the beginning. I'm going to close this tracker. Select the tracker one here in the timeline. And then in the tracker panel, I'll click on track motion again to get a second tracker. And then I'll repeat the same steps. So first I'll click on options and I'll give After Effects the ability to adapt. So let's see how this works by default. So I'll click on the analyze forward. And in this case, I think it looks quite good until this point. And when you see that it drifts away, just go back, find the last good spot and repeat the same steps that I showed you before. So you can go back to this options menu, change to stop tracking, change the confidence level and continue to monitor it. So you'll get a more accurate result. Now, since this is more or less the same thing, I'm just going to speed up this process. In this case, the biker is leaving the frame, so I can't track those pixels. I'm just going to compensate manually after the next stage. So let's just zoom out and return back to the start. Remember that we have two trackers. We basically need to connect each one of them to different nulls. So I'm going to make sure nothing is selected, then go to the layer menu and create a new null object. This is going to be biker one. And then I'll duplicate it and name it Biker 2. Okay, now I'll select the clip again, and this is going to highlight the tracker panel. Make sure to select tracker number one, then click on Edit Target, and I want to apply the motion data to Biker number one, which is the null that I've just created. So I'll click OK, and then I'll click Apply, and OK again for both X and Y dimensions. And now we should have Biker number one attached to the biker one. Lovely. We're going to change the color to, let's say, cyan, and then return back to the clip. We may need to click again on the layer panel to activate the tracker panel. Change the current track to tracker number two. Click on edit target. And this one needs to be applied to biker number two. So I'll click OK over here and then apply and OK again. And now biker number two is this guy, and I can change the color to, let's go with purple and monitor its progress so you can see how this works. All right, I need to fix this null so it will continue to track when this biker is leaving the screen. I'm going to extrapolate it manually. So I'll close everything over here. I'll press P to see the position keyframes, and then I'll move my current time indicator over here. And then I need to grab the null object and move it. And this can be very challenging. You can see that I'm not really grabbing the null, I'm grabbing one of the keyframes. So my recommended workflow is to move it from the timeline and just extrapolate where it needs to be. So somewhere over here, and then move the current time indicator again. And this time it should be more easier to just grab it and move it and approximate where it needs to be. So let's say over here, and then I'll go to the end and grab it, and let's just place it somewhere here. And we can also, if we want, change the curviness of the path. Totally up to you. It's not super important. It's just a manual fix for the motion, which is outside of the frame. I'm also going to remove all those last keyframes over here, so we'll have a smoother motion going outside of the frame and entering back. All right, I'll fit back the viewer and I'll close this biker layer, go to the beginning, and now we are ready to add some smoky particles. To do it, I'll create a new solid. I'll name it Smoke 1. Click OK. And from the Effect menu under Simulation, I'll select CC Particle System 2. By default, this looks like this, so we need to modify the settings as well as connect the producer to the position of the null object. So let's start with this. I'm going to hold down Option and click on the stopwatch, and this is going to show it to me here on the timeline. Then I can select the layer and double tap the letter E. So EE in sequence is going to show me only the properties with expressions. Now I'm going to select biker number one, press P so I can see its position. And then I'll use the property pick whip and connect this position to the position of the null object. So now it is moving with the bicycle, but it looks horrible. So let's modify the settings over here. I'll change the longevity to 4, and then I'll open up the physics, change the animation to direction, change the velocity to 0 as well as gravity. And now it looks like this. I think I want to inherit some of the original velocity. So let's try negative 20, which is just going to make it appear more natural. And to achieve that, we'll need to change the particle type. So I'll change it from line to shaded and faded sphere. And then I'll change the birth size to 0.1 and the depth size to 0.5. And of course, we can also change the size variation. Let's go with 100. And instead of fade out, let's do fade in and out. And also change the maximum opacity to 15. You can see that it already starts to look quite interesting. It will look even better if we'll change the transfer mode to screen, as well as change the blend mode of the entire layer to screen as well. And now we can play with the colors. So this one, I think, will be some sort of a navy blue color. I'm actually going to set both birth and death color to the same one. Let's go to the start and press spacebar to see how this works. Now, we are creating particles from this radius over here, which is just too big. So let's try to reduce it to maybe 1 by 1. And you can go even with smaller values depending on what you want. But I think this looks a little bit more convincing. Now, all we need to do is just duplicate this particle system. So Command D to duplicate it. I'll rename it Smoke 2. And I'll press EE to see the expression. This time, I need to connect it to biker number 2, so I'll press P again to show the position of this null object, and repeat the same steps. This time, I'll drag the property pick whip to sample the particles from this layer, and then I'll return back to the particle, maybe change the color. So let's go with something like this, or maybe a dark crimson color, and I'll take the depth color from the birth color. I'm also going to change the random seed to something else, so it's not going to be exactly the same smoke. And then I'll go to the start and preview and see how this works. And with any luck, it's going to look really nice. The last thing that we need to do is just bring those bikers above the motion tracking title. All we need to do is select the main video layer, duplicate it, drag it above everything. I'm going to remove the mocha effect from it. As well as also, let's just delete the motion trackers. So it's not going to bump up the size of the project. And then I'll go to Effect, Keying, and choose the Color Range effect. I'll go to the start. I think it's going to be the easiest place to begin. And then I'll sample the color of the background. And in the Effects preview, I'll click to sample more colors. And this is going to help us isolate those bikers above everything else, which just looks lovely. Finally, I'm going to create a new adjustment layer above everything. Then go to Effect, Distort, and apply the Transform effect. I'm at the beginning. I'm going to create a keyframe for the scale. go to the end and change it to 150 just to push even more into the title. I'll select the layer, press U to see the keyframes, and then click on the word scale to select both of them. Press F9 to ease their motion and maximize the frame, and of course, preview the result. And now you know how to track and fix issues manually, connect particles with tracking data, and comp everything together like a pro. If you find this useful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and then hop to your moped, scooter, bike, or even rollerblades. Take a break from After Effects and enjoy the ride. But hey, if it's pouring outside, cozy up here and click on the playlist that you are seeing on screen to keep mastering motion tracking in After Effects.